Well, thank you for staying with us. This is ANN7's SA Decides 2. We're coming to you from the Northern Cape. We are in Emtanjeni Municipality. Let me reintroduce my guests to you. I have the Executive Mayor with me, Mayor Sipho Stonga. We also have a DA male candidate, Mr. Jacobus Rust. We also have an independent candidate, Councillor Vuyelwa Jonasi. But as the second half of the program, it's time for us to go to the masses. Like I told you before, we have members from different political parties that will help us to gauge the mood of the community as to what they can expect come the municipal elections on the 3rd of August. I understand in the crowd we have a member from the ANC who has a question or comment. Go ahead, sir.
Good afternoon, ma'am, and thank you very much for this opportunity. My question is addressed to the DA. The DA is always bragging about caring about people, about the human race. And this question I must ask in Afrikaans, so that they can get a right answer in Afrikaans from Mr. Rust. En wil net so 'n kort tikkie terugvat, Mr. Rust, in ons streek hier na Prieska toe, waar die DA members bymekaar gemaak het vir 'n rally en hulle vervoer het op 'n skaaptrok. That is inhumane. Nou, u is 'n party, nou vra ek vir u die vraag. Is dit die party wat in die aar in bewind moet kom om weer van ons as mense diere te maak? Ek dink ons is lankal verby daai tyd wat ons misbruik maak van anders kleeriges. Kom ons kyk daarna jou gehoor ook. Jy sien nooit, ek is nou baie jammer om dit te sê, maar in Prieska by die skaaptrok staan die wit met hom. Sy stoot almal op om op te klim op hierdie skaaptrok. Ek glo nie dat ons in hierdie moderne eeu en in hierdie pragtige Emtanjeni munisipaliteit van ons 'n rassistiese party kry om ons te kom regeer nie. Is dit wat u vir ons wil bring, DA?
Well, thank you there. That's a remark from an ANC member, Mr. Rust. I'll give you an opportunity to respond.
Baie dankie vir die geleentheid. Ek sal graag die geagte vriend ook in Afrikaans wil antwoord. Ek verstout my om te sê dat die vragmotor waarna hy verwys het definitief nie aan die DA behoort nie en nie deur die DA glo ek so intoe gestuur is nie. Ek vermoed dit is die plaaseienaar se eie vragmotor gewees in die geval. Is my aanname. En die mense het dalk vir hom 'n geleentheid gevra. Ek glo nie hy het hulle opgeforceer nie, want ek hoor die blanke dame, as far as I could gather from this guy here in the audience, the lady helped them onto the truck. Didn't force them onto the truck. Helped them onto the truck. So I definitely won't go that far to say that is the DA. Maar Kom ons gaan verder. Die agbare lid van die publiek verwys na die DA en rasisme. Die liewe vriend slaap seker vir die laaste 10 jaar redelik vas. Want rasisme is lankal by die agterdeur uit. Die nasionale leier van die DA het gesê, en ek haal hom aan, en ek vertaal dit oor in Afrikaans. Sou enige iemand met rassistiese neigings, dit begin daar by Penny Sparrow, my vriend, ek weet nie of jy weet van haar nie, sou enige iemand 'n rasis wees of rassisties optree in die DA, moet hy of sy asseblief die DA verlaat.
Well, thank you for your response. I do hope, sir, that you have been answered. I understand we have more questions coming from the audience. Another ANC member, please go ahead and introduce yourself and your question or comment.
Oh, dankie vir die geleentheid. My vraag is aan die meier, Comrade Stonga. Eerstens, meier, wil ons as die jeug van Emtanjeni, wil ons sê dankie vir die meierlikheid wat van tyd tot tyd afkom. Ons is inderdaad baie dankbaar daarvoor, as jong mense. So, ons moet ook die goeie kan sê wat die regerende partij vir ons as jong mense doen. Maar my vraag is, meier, as die meier van Emtanjeni, het ons currently probleme met sports faciliteite. Ons wil net weet dat hoe die die regerende party ons sportfasilities gaan opgradeer en wanneer dit gaan wees. My tweede vraag is die identification of talent. Ons het verskillende sportsoorte wat beoefen word in de Aar of in Mthanjeni. Maar ons sportspelers stagneer op een plek. So ons wil weet of ons wil vra hoe kan ons regerende party, ons het baie talentvolle spelers, hoe kan ons hulle vorentoe vat en nie net in de Aar bly of in Mthanjeni bly en hulle talente word in ander plekke gesien nie. Dankie.
Well, thank you for those requests and comments there. Executive Mayor, would you care to answer to this gentleman?
Thank you. The mayoral cup, when it started initially, it started with one coach. But because strategically we had an intention of building social cohesion amongst the citizens of Mthanjeni. Deliberately, we decided to extend it from being one code game into mayoral games, whereby all sport codes are included. Yes, I agree to say that the facilities are a challenge. But that challenge, there is already a plan on that challenge to say, because Mthanjeni is a hub for solar and for wind alternative energy. Now there's a lot of developers that has come to our shores who are keen and prepared to assist the municipality in order to fast track the issue of developing sport facilities, whereby all the youth, different codes, will be able then to develop themselves and to play sport. So we are venturing into that with those developers that are in our municipality to go forward. But as I'm talking of social cohesion, we are also trying maybe to spread this word to say that we are emulating what the first democratic president of this country has done in building the nation, whereby he used the sport to build this nation that we call the Rainbow Nation that we are so proud about. If you remember the rugby of 1995, it was the first time that some of us hugged the people of different race. But that was the initiative that Mandela put in place to build the nation. So the social cohesion that the ANC is talking about in the manifesto, we have already started with that in Mthanjeni, whereby we are reaching out to different communities and different ethnic and racial groups in our municipality in an attempt to bring them together through sport with different codes through the mayoral sport games that are there. The talent scouts scouting of your talent, as Mthanjeni, we've already started with that. It's only to say it has not been filtered through into all the other different wards. 2 weeks ago, there were games that were played in one of the areas of Mthanjeni that is called Hanover, whereby one of our partners, that is SCATEC, brought in scouts to come and scout talent as there were games. And he brought in some coaches to come and coach the local coaches in an attempt to develop the coaching skills of the coaches in order to be able to produce the relevant skills to those players and those sports men and women that are participating there. But that is also on one front. But with the youth of Mthanjeni, there is a package that we're having. As the ruling party, strategically, we introduced in Mthanjeni what we called the youth unit in the municipality. That is manned by young people who went around in all the wards establishing youth forums, whereby youth come together, discuss youth issues, and bring them to council to find the attention and be addressed. We have started with that long ago. The unit is up and running. It is addressing the plight of the young people in Mthanjeni. We are not ending there as Mthanjeni. The engagements that are there with all our partners that I'm referring to, it's also to put in place bursary schemes that will make sure that all those who are matriculating will receive bursaries to attend for further education. In so doing, there's already engagement with Solplage. Solplage University was here. Solplage University has engaged the communities, everyone know, through the partnership with the municipality to make sure that Solplage come and explain to the community what are the programs and what curriculum opportunities are there in Solplage. Now, those are the opportunities that are there, that as the ANC-led council, we have initiated and introduced in an attempt to build capacity amongst the young people, both on talent and also on education, in order for us to have a nation that is healthy and a nation that is capable to grow the economy of the country.
Well, thank you for your response, Executive Mayor. They're speaking of the youth and sports, the importance of transformation as well as inclusion and social cohesion. I want to believe there's more questions coming from the audience. I see we have a member there. I'm not sure. So please introduce yourself and who you want to pose your question to my panelists here.
Ek is Etienne Lavak. Ek is inwoner van de Aar. Ek is 'n besigheid, as 'n kontrakteur. Vir die afgelope 22 jaar wil ek graag die regering vra, vir MTN Jenny vra, hoeveel besighede is al gedevelop? Dus, en ek wil graag weet hoeveel, en die laaste, die tweede punt is, die brein besighede, persone, word nie gedevelop in die dorpie. En die ekonomie van die dorp, bly nie in die dorp nie. Die geld van die dorp gaan uit die dorp uit. Alle contracteer wat hier in die dorp kom kry die contract in die Aaren. Geen contracteers in die dorp word gebruik nie. Geen contracteers groei in die dorp nie, want hulle kry nie die kans om te groei nie. Hulle kry nie die geleentheid om vorentoe te gaan nie.
Please allow him to finish his question, ladies and gentlemen.
En dis die challenge wat die local besighede sit. Ons het, hier is die Solok besighede wat in de Aar is. Geen local contracteurs is daar gebruik by Solok nie. Die windpaneel is hier so. Geen local besighede is hier gebruik nie. En die twee, en die laatste ene van my, sekere besighede.
Okay, let's wrap it up, sir, and just consolidate our questions so we can quickly go to our panelists. The other people want to ask questions as well.
Okay, dan stel ek af, dankie.
Okay, I want to assume this question is for the executive mayor. Mayor, would you care to respond to this question of contract?
The upcoming contractors, the SMMEs, I want also to assist maybe the second questions that will come into play. In partnership with Sportnet to start with, because what is happening that cry that Mr. Lavak is referring to, and in concluding, I will come direct to Mr. Lavak what we have done for him as a person. Now, in partnership with the Sportnet and other role players, we engaged the provincial government and we got a go-ahead that let the SMME hub be established here in DR, just one street from here, where small businesses get assistance of all sorts, starting from registration, starting from assisting them with their tax clearances. All that includes SMME, or the requirement that SMME should have. Because what we have picked up, the SMMEs are making noise that they are not given opportunities. But when you bring them in, they don't meet the necessary requirements because their papers and their requirements are not in order. Now, in order to curb that as the municipality, in order to have role players at that level that are ready, we brought in the SMME through the several engagements that were there. And now the SMME hub is here up and running. They are harnessing knowledge and assistance from there. And now, that has been now the thing of the past, because in the past, all SMMEs, if not the majority of them, were having the cry, but they could not be assisted because their papers were not in order. That is one. Number two, on the issue of the SMMEs. As a municipality, the SMMEs, if they are assisted by the Department of Labor, if they are assisted by Department of Culture, they are not assisted. In order for them to realize that they are assisted, they must either get a tender from a municipality, then they are assisted. We want to erase that because we are a government. Whether we are at this sphere, but we are a government that is working together with the province and national and the sector departments. You need to grow as an SMME, whether you get work from whatever department, grow. Don't always be someone that is stagnant, because what is happening? Today, people like Mr. Lavak are assisted today. 6 months down the line, they are in the same space that they were 6 months ago. With all the necessary assistance that one has received, with all the necessary exposure that one has given, and the capital injection that one has received, but it's still stagnated on the same. Hence now we have made this easy to say that, let the hub be here. Let us take this burden away from the municipality and let the hub assist the SMMEs to go forward. I'm of the view now, if there can be opportunities, in our data that is here, all those SMMEs that are in the data have the necessary skills, have the necessary papers that are needed, so as far as to not have that, because that is the thing of the past. The only thing that is there are no opportunities as yet from the side of the municipality. I'm not talking on behalf of the sector departments, because there might be opportunities in sector departments, but as I'm saying, the attitude of the SMM is in our area. If they are not assisted by the municipality, they are not assisted at all.
Right.
They must be assisted in order for them to feel that, no, on this rare help. Alle moet die municipality ga help word. Al wat hulle help by die ANA sector departments, no, that is not enough. It must be the municipality. We are a category B municipality. Our budget is less than 250 million. And 237 thereof, it's on operation budget. And on operation budget, we don't cater for SMMEs. It has to be on the capital budget, which is very limited. As a municipality, we won't be able to carry the SMMEs and the number of SMMEs that we are having. Hence, we are doing this initiative to assist them somewhere else in order for them to venture. But right, ma'am, your business as an SMME is your business. Run it. Don't want the municipality to run the business for you.
Right, thank you for your response. I do hope that you have been answered. It's a very elaborate answer there coming from the executive mayor. Ladies and gentlemen, please, if we may maintain some kind of order. We have a member from the Democratic Alliance. Please identify yourself, sir, and your question or comment to our panelists.
Okay, baie dankie, dame. Open die after van die DA. Die stelling of vraagstelling wat ek nog gaan maak is gerig aan albei partye. Die ANC en die DA. Ek dink hulle gaan saam met my stem dat dienslewering is hoog op hulle prioriteitslys. Dienslewering kan alleenlik gebeur of plaasvind as mense betrokke is. Ek dink dit is, jy kan met my daarmee saamstem. As ons kyk van 1 uur af, byvoorbeeld, as jy gaan kyk, hier is ambtenare, munisipale ambtenare, hier is staatsambtenare binnen hierdie groep hier. Wat is julle ten opsigte van dit? Want as ons gaan mense, wat veronderstel is om dienst te lever, en hulle sit hier van, en dit is pas 3 nou. Gaan u asseblief vir ons kan sê, meneer van die DA en burgemeester, wat is u partij se stans ten opsigte van dit? Baie dankie.
Well, thank you for your question, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Anyone here who is not private or didn't take leave from his work is stealing from somebody and is holding somebody away from the service he or she was supposed to render to public if it's a public servant. I quite agree, I'm against it, it doesn't work that way. Like I have often said in council, and that goes for the municipal staff, we are not getting salaries, we are earning salaries.
Right. right. Well, thank you for that response. I hope we're making some kind of headway there as we get questions from our audience here. Just a reminder, we are coming to you from the Northern Cape in Emtanjeni Municipality. This is the second town hall debate of SA Decides 2. We have a member from the ANC, so please identify yourself and your question.
Thanks for the opportunity that I've received. My name is Mkolisi Mali, staying in Ward 4 at Emtanjeni. I think it's very important, firstly, to highlight one thing. We as the people that are staying in Emtanjeni, we want first to appreciate what the council have done to us, particularly being run by an ANC-led government. This question will then, it's a comment first to the mayor. Mayor, there was a survey that was done. It was not done by the ANC, it was not done by the DA, but it was done independently. Where Emtanjeni was placed as number 9 best performing municipality in the country. It went furthermore to say all the Rand ANC municipality, Emtanjeni is number 1. One should appreciate that. As I was emphasizing, it's not a survey done by the ANC anyway. So what my question is then is to say, Mayor, what do we have in place going forward to maintain this standard? And I believe you raised something very sharp that we've got skilled people that are within the municipality. It means then we should maintain them. And then what are we going to do going forward? And I believe we can achieve that by the manifest of the ANC that is also there, that we must go to the community. The second one and the last one was the appreciation that you do as an ANC-led municipality, consulting the community all times. You raised that there is a budget that should be adopted next week, Tuesday. But you went around to all the wards, seeking clarification in order to adopt that. That it means the municipality belongs to the people. We appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you for that question, sir. A very good question coming from one of the community members, Executive Mayor, acknowledging that, as the ANC, you have done a great job in maintaining service delivery and just facilities around the municipality. It also speaks of communication structures being in place. They're happy with that. But in terms of maintaining the record that you have as being the best in the Northern Cape and the 9th in the whole country, what do you have in place to make sure that you maintain that and to even surpass it?
On a lighter note first, you see, I belong to the ANC. Now I know that I'm only left with the 3 months, if not less than that, to the 3rd of August. Because in the ANC, we don't have a luxury like the other parties to know that you are a mayoral candidate up until those processes are concluded. Now, I'll talk for the remaining time where we are going to lay the foundation for those that will come in. I'm happy my colleague next to me said that we are doing something right. They even acknowledge as the opposition to say we are doing something right. We appreciate that. Now, in the light of that, ma'am, what we need to sustain, from 2006, ma'am, even the audit of the municipality was very bad. But in the last 4 years, it's safe to say that we are constantly growing. Because as the municipality, one, we put structures in place. We have a committee that is called the MPEC, that is led by the opposition in our municipality to show that we are transparent. Yeah, it's led by the opposition, show that we are transparent. That is monitoring the performance of the municipality. Now, those structures will ensure to say that we are sustaining this through systems that we have put in place. Because there are systems, I don't want to bore you with the details. There are systems that we have put into place to ensure that we improve on our audit outcome, we improve on our governance issues, we improve on finance management, we improve on public participation. Those systems are in place. And to make sure that those systems are being there, this current financial year, that the last financial year that we are coming from, we received an unqualified audit opinion, of course, with matters that we are working on through the action plan that were given by the Auditor General, rectifying two or three queries that the auditor is having in order to retain and to maintain a clean audit. We are striving, ma'am, to be the first category B municipality in Peaks Lake Aseme to receive a clean audit. We are committing ourselves to that, to say that we strive for that, because we are sure of the systems that we have put into place. We are sure of the skilled personnel that we are having there to say that that can be achieved. Right. Is it not true?
I'm happy to see you two gentlemen agreeing on something. Any more questions from our audience?
We will carry on with it.
Yes, sir. Please, your name and your question or comment.
Nkolani Skei, Wasianova. Ndicela ucela imeyara ibakhumbuze bonke kule minyaka oko esesituleni into azenzileyo kusuka eHanover ukuzeya eDR kweBrixtown ezikhombekayo noba segxekile emva kuba ezogxekika bangazilibali ezo nto.
Thank you for your question, sir. Would you care to respond to that?
The question says that can the mayor remind us that what are the achievements that they have achieved from when they assumed the position up until now? What are the achievements that they have achieved?
I couldn't have said it better, Mayor. Thank you for that. Please do answer to that.
Up to DR. Just on a lighter note again, ma'am. Am I on the floor?
Well, you have taken the floor. We'll allow you to finish.
I want to acknowledge the gentleman that is seated here.
Yes.
The one with the red cap. Ublegi van Staden. He's my former speaker in the ANC. When I came in 2006, he was the speaker in the ANC.
Right.
In council. I respect him. He's got experience in council. But I'm just pleading, he must not put it to waste. Now.
That sounds like a very, very serious note, councillor.
No, no, I want to come to the issue.
Okay, may we allow Mr. Russ to answer the question that was posed from the floor? What do you have in terms of accountability with the time that you're given when you governed the places that he spoke of?
Like the mayor said, we've only got 3 months, just about 3 months remaining of our term. What's going to happen after the 3rd of August? Everybody wished, but nobody knows. We will maintain the good work, and we will better the defects and the faults being made. And like I said, service delivery is to utmost importance to any municipality. And after the 3rd of August 2016, when the DA takes over this municipality, we will carry on with the good work and the good foundation laid by my friend next to me.
Thank you for your remarks. Unfortunately, I have to close the floor in terms of questions. We are running out of time. It is time for closing remarks. Councillor Jonas, you have been very quiet. This is your opportunity for closing remarks.
Thank you, ma'am, for this opportunity. I only have one thing to say to the people. More especially the people of the ward that I'm leading now. You vote for independent, you waste your vote. The experience that I had this 5 years, if I have not worked with ANC, that ward would have not got anything. So
very quickly, ma'am, we're really running out of time.
So what I will say, whoever that is even thinking of standing as an independent, erase that in your mind.
Thank you very much. Executive Mayor, very quickly, 30 seconds as we close down the show.
Ma'am, we are a better run municipality. And that is why the DA is targeting to get, because DA is targeting all the better run municipality in order for them not to do nothing, to get municipalities that are ready. As the ANC is saying, ma'am, we want to improve on service delivery. We want to improve on local economy. We want to strengthen public participation. We want to make sure that education, as the apex of the ANC, we mobilize all role players in education in order to prioritize and to improve education in our localities. And lastly, ma'am, social cohesion is of cardinal importance. We can never, at this juncture in our democracy, to still have pockets of racism amongst the residents of Mthanjeni.
We need to erase it. Executive Mayor, unfortunately, we have run out of time. Let me take this opportunity to thank my panelists. Here we had the Executive Mayor of Mthanjeni Municipality, Mayor Sipho Stonga. We also had DA mayoral candidate, Mr. Jacobus Rust. We also had an independent candidate with us, Councillor Vuyelwa Jonasi. Very important, we had residents here in our audience who were giving us their concerns and their comments and how they feel as we approach the 3rd of August, the municipal elections. Mthanjeni, are you ready to decide? Yeah! There you have it. We're coming to you from the Northern Cape. This is SA Decides.